After 2 years of closed doors, the Beirut Marathon Women's Race is taking place today. 394 women will run for 10 kilometers. So let's see how it goes.
I'm walking alone, the streets are empty. The only thing I can see is my own silhouette.
Today you broke the record with 35 minutes and 35 seconds. Tell us about your experience, and is it your first time?
So first time doing a 10K. It was really nice. It was really a very great course and amazing to be here again in Lebanon and racing.
And your sister won the second prize?
Correct, yes. So the sister took the 1 and 2 on the podium this year.
We always challenge each other.
Always. You know, we are sisters and we love each other, but when we're competing, we are definitely competing with each other. So it makes it a lot of fun as well because it's challenging.
And what do you think are her strong points, the strong points that you don't have?
I think she's a strong runner, and I think she, you know, she's willing to stay with me, even so, you know, sometimes it's, I don't know, she's not afraid, so it makes me push myself even harder.
Nisreen, right?
Yes,
you won the second prize?
Yes, I was second today.
And how do you feel about that?
I'm actually very happy to be here. I mean, I finished second after my sister, the Olympic runner. So I'm very proud actually to be participating in this race. Every day, sometimes you have challenges. The best way to do is to get up, dress up, and show up, you know? And this is the message I want to convey. Sometimes I don't feel like running, but you know, I just take the first step. And once I'm done, I'm feeling very grateful and happy.
This is your first event after the blast and the pandemic. How does it feel being present here at this moment in Beirut and after all that happened?
Well, I don't want to sound too predictable and say it's so exciting, but indeed it is very exciting. The energy that we witnessed this morning from the participants, we call them the peace runners, and they are indeed peace runners. They came united and they're running together for a better tomorrow, for a better Lebanon, and hopefully for a better economy.
Tell me about this event. It's dedicated for women.
Absolutely. You know, the hashtag that we raise is called Anamaki, and asking the woman to continue pushing the bar. So we would like women to push the bar, run the 10 kilometer, and later on they will join our training program, which we call 5-4-2. We train them from 5 weeks before the event to do the 42 kilometers. So we take them from zero to hero.
في صعوبات بتواجهوها بالتريننج؟
بالنسبة للتريننج لا ما في صعوبات، كنا عم نشتغل شهر وشوي معهم فكانوا مبسوطين وكنا دايماً عم نحمسهم، كرمال هيك كانوا قدروا يكفوا لهيدا اليوم، لو ما وصلوا يعني اخذوا مثلاً نمبر 1 هن اعتبروا حالهم انه ربحوا.
رغم كل الأوضاع اللي عم نمر فيها بالبلد، المرأة ما في شيء بيوقفها.
How was participating in this marathon? Tell us about your experience.
Okay, so Beirut Marathon is a very beautiful race. Women's race is where I started to run, and I won my first podium here in 2008. I wanted to participate again, and it was a very good experience. The race was very well organized. The water stations were good on time. The weather was fine. There were cheerleaders a lot. The elite runners were amazing, and I finished my 10K race, and I'm so glad I did it.
What would you like to tell all the women in Lebanon?
Yeah, I want to tell them that don't be afraid to follow your dreams. No matter what it takes, you can do this.
Thank Thank you so much, and I wish you all the best.
Thank you. Thanks so much.
على طول بتشاركوا بهيك ايفنتات، شو بتحب تقولي لنا اليوم وشو المساج اللي بدكم توصلوه وكيف كانت الاكسبيرينس؟
مثل ما لاحظتي في ناس من جميع الطوائف من جميع المناطق، ما حدا بيعرف مين الثاني وما حدا بيسال شو بيشتغل او شو بيعمل الثاني، وكلهم موجودين هون بالساحه. هيدي الرساله تبع الصليب الاحمر ورساله تبع الماراثون. اليوم بما انه الماراثون منه كبير مثل العاده، نازلين ثلاث سيارات، حاطين سياره على الانطلاق وعلى الوصول، سياره على المونرو، سياره على المناره، وعاملين خيمه مستشفى لان في من العدائين بيتضايقوا شوي هن واصلين.
I would love to know more about your NGO and how are you supporting and attending this event. Like, tell me about your participation, about your NGO.
We are Frontline Engineers NGO. We are here to run for a cause, women empowerment, youth, and rehab of damaged building of Beirut. Since the blast and till now, we are helping with the rehab of Beirut's building, the damaged buildings.
نحن بنشجع هيك ايفنتس سبيشلي بعد الحجر الصحي وبعد هيك قصص، بلشنا نحس انه الحياه شوي عم ترجع، يعني كثير مبسوطين نحن بالفايبس اللي صاروا، وان شاء الله كل ما يصير هيك ايفنتس نحن اول ناس ان شاء الله على طول.
So basically today I'm here, I'm supporting the woman race, and I think that every woman has the right to speak and nobody has to be quiet. And I think what we're doing here is, you can see after, especially after the blast that happened, it's a very big success to see all the women gathering all together and supporting one another.
حنبقى ثابتين بوجه الدنيا بوجه المستحيلات، وبحب ارجع وجه رساله لمي الخليل، رساله شكر على انه الاوضاع صح ما منيحه بس عم تخلي الناس عندها امل بالحياه. شكرا لكم.
It was real fun attending the women's race today, and one of the participants gave me this medal. I love it so much. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time. شو المساج يلي حابب كنت توصله اليوم؟
بدنا الدولة توقف حد الرياضة أكثر وأكثر وتدعم الرياضة، ويجي وزير للرياضة يهتم بالرياضة أكثر وأكثر.